में मालूम मालूम पड़ा ऑपरेशन थिएटर में सब गड़बड़, लाइट नहीं कुछ नहीं। There also time studies to be done, so that you are again and again coming up with better methods of reducing the time for the operations, serving time for the customers, doing the time study as to how many patients to be treated by how many doctors, or how many doctors should be appointed, or how many ward boys to be appointed, and how many patients should the ward boy handle. Again, you are giving a target. Right. TQM, Total Quality Management. Now, Total Quality Management is a concept which is very simple to understand but very difficult to implement. TQM talks about totality of attributes and features of an organization which bear upon its ability to satisfy the customer. To understand what is TQM, very simple, let us assume you have made a telephone call to a company or to anyone, and if he is not picking up and ring is going on, what will you feel? Kaisa aadmi phone bhi nahi uthata hai. So is there a quality? You go to an organization, idhar udhar kachra pada hua hai, is there quality? You go to an organization, appointment fixed is 10 o'clock, 10:30 baje tak koi milne ke liye nahi aaya, koi dhang se baat nahi kar raha, is there quality? So TQM talks about totality of quality. Quality not just in production, quality related to everything in the organization. Organization mein galat bill bana diya, quality hai? Nahi. So bill banane mein bhi quality hoti hai. So TQM talks about totality of attributes and features related to everything in the organization. Even talking has quality. Right? So TQM talks about all this. And there are certain basic philosophies behind TQM. First philosophy behind TQM is customer focus or customer satisfaction. It says any TQM organization must ensure that customers are satisfied. And customer does not mean a person who buys from us. Anyone who comes in our contact is a customer. Company mein koi aadmi aaya milne ke liye, he is also a customer, no? If you don't satisfy him properly, don't treat him properly, what will happen? Us company mein gaya tha, koi dhang se baat bhi nahi karta, kaisi company hai, bekar, quality khatam ho gayi na. So it talks about customer focus, where it says that we must satisfy every customer or every person who comes in our contact. Company mein time pe payment bhi nahi karte, supplier bolta hai time pe payment nahi karte, so again he has to be satisfied, otherwise quality is not there. Or quality is there, but total is not there. So TQM talks about customer focus or customer satisfaction, where customer is anyone who comes in our contact. Right? Second aspect of TQM is Kaizen. Kaizen means, Kaizen is a Japanese word, which is K-A-I-K-Z-E-N-Zen, which talks about continuous improvement. It says that we must keep on improving on continuous basis. It should never stop. It should not be felt, nahi itna ho gaya, bahut ho gaya, ab isse aage improvement nahi karna hai. It says there is always a scope for improvement. If you are here, you can go here. If you are here, you can go here. If you are here, you can go here. And that can be measured also. Quality levels can be measured. And that measurement is in terms of sigma. Sigma talks about standard deviation. It talks about percentage of data within a normal distribution curve. Aapka statistics hua nahi hai, isliye abhi ye zyada samjha nahi sakta hu. But it talks about number of defects which could occur. Like 6 sigma quality level means this quality level ensures that there are not more than 32 errors in 10 million. That is, 1 crore mein 32 se zyada galtiyan nahi honi chahiye. 10 लाख में 3.2, तो 10 लाख प्रोडक्ट आपने बनाया तो उसमें से सिर्फ 3.2 से कम आपके प्रोडक्ट खराब होने चाहिए, देन यू गेट अ लेवल ऑफ 6 सिग्मा. एंड देयर आर ओनली 3 ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस हैव व्हिच हैव रीच्ड दिस 6 सिग्मा लेवल, जनरल इलेक्ट्रिक, मोटरोला एंड मुंबई डब्बा वाला. ओनली थ्री पीपल हु हैव रीच दिस लेवल. सिक्स सिग्मा. ऑफ कोर्स देयर आर सम ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस व्हिच वर्क एट 8 सिग्मा एंड 10 सिग्मा. 8 सिग्मा मीन्स लेस देन 1 एरर इन 1 बिलियन. 1 बिलियन इज 100 करोड़. 100 करोड़ में 1 से कम गलती होनी चाहिए. तो 100 करोड़ प्रोडक्ट बनाओगे तो उसमें से 1 से कम गलती. लॉट ऑफ एयरलाइंस वर्क ऑन दिस कि 100 करोड़ फ्लाइट अगर उड़ेंगी तो उसमें 1 से ज्यादा फ्लाइट गिरनी नहीं चाहिए. राइट. सो कंटिन्यूअस इंप्रूवमेंट फॉर विच इट सेज यू मस्ट फॉलो अ साइकिल विच इज PDCA. Plan, do, check, act. Plan the improvement. Do the improvement, check the results, act on it. Plan what you want to improve, try it out, check the results. If results are okay, act on it or implement. Plan the next improvement. Keep on doing this. The cycle should keep on happening. Right? The next component of TQM is employee empowerment. What employee empowerment means is the quality can be improved or quality can be achieved only if you have people who are empowered. Empowered means what? Who are allowed to take authority or allowed to make decisions. We give them the authority, empower them to take decisions. For this, 2 things have to be done. One, you have to give them authority, but before giving authority, you have to train them. So train the employees, give them proper training, give them authority, and make them accountable for quality. That is employee empowerment. Because employees are not responsible for problems, but they can solve the problem. Like, agar koi machine kharab hoti hai, to shayad wo kharab kiski wajah se hui, aap uska spare part खराब हुआ या खराब था, एम्प्लॉय की वजह से तो नहीं हुई. बट अगर एम्प्लॉय को अथॉरिटी नहीं होगी स्पेयर पार्ट चेंज करने की तो क्या करेगा, वो चलने देगा. सो यू हैव टू एम्पावर हिम टू मेक डिसीजंस एज टू विच स्पेयर पार्ट शुड बी चेंज, विच स्पेयर पार्ट शुड बी यूज्ड. नॉट सेइंग जो दिया है उससे काम करो, देन यू आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट क्वालिटी. बिकॉज एम्प्लॉय मे नॉट बी रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द फेलियर, but he can control the failure. Right? Okay. That is as far as TQM is concerned. Now we can take a break for 5 minutes and then start with the remaining topics. Materials management. Now, materials management is management of material. Now, in any organization, there is a material which is incoming into the organization, and managing of that material is part of materials management activity. So for doing this, what are the activities that have to be performed? You have to procure the material or get the material inside, which is called as purchasing. Then you have to store that material and then issue that material to the required place. So procurement, storage, and handling, material handling. These are the basic 3 functions of the materials management. But apart from that, when you are talking about procurement, you also need to decide how much quantity to be procured and how much quantity to be stored. And that part is handled by inventory management. or that part is called as inventory management, where you decide how much quantity to be purchased or how much quantity to be stored based on certain parameters, which we'll look at it shortly. Apart from that, whatever metal is surplus or whatever scrap is generated or waste is generated during the process, that material also has to be handled. So, which is a scrap disposal activity, which also has to be done by the materials department. Now, one more activity is planning the material, which material, when to purchase, and how much to purchase is a planning process, which is part of materials planning. Now, in material planning, one of the process of planning or deciding which material and how much to be purchased is called as material requirement planning, MRP. Under MRP, we go by the sales forecast. Based on the sales forecast, we'll know how much quantity of material is required to be produced. Based on quantity to be produced, we'll know the material required. Like, let us take up an example. We want to make pizzas for some guests. So let us assume 4 guests are coming to your place. How many pizzas will have to be made? Kitne pizza banane padenge? 4 guests aane wale. Simple question pucha hai, iska to answer aana chahiye. 5 or 6? Ek fixed quantity hogi na? Okay, let us assume 6. Now, 6 pizzas are required. Now, 6 pizza banane ke liye, pizza toh direct nahi banta na. You will require certain material. What is the first thing that will be required for making pizza? Pizza base. How many? 6. Apart from pizza base, what is required? Apart from pizza base, what is required for making pizza? Cheese. How much? 10 per pizza kitna chahiye hoga? 10 product complicated hai kya? Thoda simple product lo kya? लेकिन देखा तो है ना, तो अप्रोक्सीमेट अंदाजा आना चाहिए ना, चीज कितना लगेगा एक पिज्जा के लिए, कितना लगता होगा? 1 किलो एक पिज्जा के लिए, 250 ग्राम. एक पिज्जा के लिए 250 ग्राम चीज, एक के लिए कितना लगेगा बोलो मेरे को? 200 ग्राम का पूरा पिज्जा मिला के नहीं होगा, सब कुछ मिला के भी. अप्रॉक्सीमेट 25-30 ग्राम, 40 ग्राम, बहुत हुआ तो 50 ग्राम, उससे ज़्यादा नहीं लगेगा ना. सो पर पिज़्ज़ा 50 ग्राम, सो 6 पिज़्ज़ा के लिए 300 ग्राम. ना 300 ग्राम चीज़ चाहिए, उसमें से ऑलरेडी 100 ग्राम चीज़ आपके पास पड़ा हुआ है, तो कितना खरीदना है? 200 ग्राम. और क्या चाहिए? विच वेजिटेबल? कैप्सिकम, ओनियन. ओनियन ऑलरेडी पड़ा हुआ है, ओनियन खरीदना है? नहीं. कैप्सिकम नहीं है, खरीदना पड़ेगा. कितना खरीदना है? एक पिज्जा पे कितने लगेंगे? मे बी हाफ. 6 पिज्जा के लिए 3 कैप्सिकम, 3 कैप्सिकम में भी 1/2 किलो. सो दिस इज अ मटेरियल रिक्वायरमेंट प्लानिंग प्रोसेस, वेयर बेस्ड ऑन द फाइनल प्रोडक्ट you decide what are the ingredients, and based on the ingredients quantity you decide how much to be purchased. This entire process of planning is called as MRP, where we decide for making each variety of product, like maybe automobile, car banane ke liye, what are the inputs which are required per car, and then multiplied by number of cars will give us the total quantity of material required. If we already have some stock, that is to be subtracted and balance to be purchased. This entire process is material requirement planning. This is one way of planning. right? Now, if you were told to do purchasing management, what will you do? आपको बोला गया कि purchasing management करना है या purchase manage करना है, क्या करना होगा? ओके, फिर वो देख के क्या करेंगे आगे? वो हो गया, फिर कितने मटेरियल लेने, मटेरियल का क्या करेंगे? हाँ, ओके, सो व्हाट विल यू डू विद दिस इंफॉर्मेशन? As a purchase person, what will you do? Inventory देख लिया, stock देख लिया, करेंगे क्या अभी ये देख के? बहुत अच्छा दिख रहा है, देख लिया. You have seen, looks good. Now what do we do? PO देंगे. किस चीज का? और क्यों? Why? कौन सा मटेरियल? एक्स्ट्रा रिक्वायरमेंट है ना, समझ में नहीं. आई एम नॉट अंडरस्टूड व्हाट इज दिस एक्स्ट्रा रिक्वायरमेंट. एक्स्ट्रा रिक्वायरमेंट है ना क्या? Can you explain with some example? You have been appointed as a purchase manager in any organization, let us assume. What are the activities that you will have to perform? What is it that you will have to do? Material manager nahi, purchase manager hai aap. So what will you do? Okay, for what?
Proper delivery of the material.
What is proper delivery?
The material you should require should be given from the supplier within particular time.
What is within particular time? Means what?
Agar kul se material ka urgency hai, so you should give that material immediately.
Immediately and samajh mein nahi aaya. Urgency hai, mere ko 3 din mein material chahiye, wo 2 minute mein dena chahiye. Mere ko 3 din mein chahiye, वो 2 मिनट में मटेरियल देना चाहिए, ऐसा कुछ है क्या? कब देना चाहिए उसने मटेरियल तुमको?
जब जरूरत
है ना. विच टाइम? टॉप, बॉटम, लेफ्ट या कौन सा टाइम? लेफ्ट या? हाँ, तो टाइम कौन सा, लेफ्ट या? ये क्या होता है? ये लेफ्ट है तो ये क्या है?
right,
तो कौन सा टाइम होना चाहिए? राइट टाइम पे ना. सो यू नीड मटेरियल एट द जल्दी वल्दी क्या होता है, राइट टाइम पे मिलना चाहिए ना. सो राइट टाइम, विच मटेरियल रिक्वायर्ड क्या होता है, लेफ्ट या
राइट
क्या? राइट प्रोडक्ट क्या होता है, प्रोडक्ट का राइट क्या होता है? One is right time. What else?
Right product means जो order किए हुए मिलना चाहिए.
मतलब क्या होता है जो order किए है ना, समझ में नहीं आया. उसमें right क्या होना चाहिए?
PO
तो हम ही देंगे ना.
Right material
क्या होना चाहिए उसमें? अभी कौन सा टॉपिक पढ़ा था इससे पहले? तो क्या होना चाहिए, राइट? तो राइट क्वालिटी का मटेरियल होना चाहिए ना. तो राइट क्वालिटी, राइट टाइम पे. और कुछ तो राइट? नो अदर राइट लेफ्ट? और इज देयर एनी अदर राइट विच हैज बीन लेफ्ट? एनी अदर राइट विच इज लेफ्ट? लेट अस टेक अप एन एग्जांपल. आपको प्यास व्यास लगती है क्या? सो लेट अस अज्यूम आपको प्यास लगी, आपने पानी मंगवाया, पानी उधर ले जाके देंगे चलेगा? तो अभी बोला तो और नो अदर राइट इज लेफ्ट, तो राइट प्लेस भी होना चाहिए ना, यस सर नो राइट, अच्छा राइट क्वांटिटी भी चाहिए। देखो अभी बोल रहे थे नो अदर राइट लेफ्ट और दो राइट और बता दिए, एनी अदर राइट लेफ्ट। सो नीचे से पानी की बोतल मंगाई है ना, नीचे वो क्या शॉप है ना, उसने भेज दी 500 रुपए में एक बोतल, चलेगा ना? प्राइस क्या होता है राइट? प्राइस, लेट अस टेक अप एन एग्जांपल, वी आर सिटिंग इन द क्लास, वी वांट वन बोतल ऑफ वाटर, एमआरपी प्रिंटेड ऑन बोतल इज 12 रुपीज, सो व्हाट इज द राइट प्राइस? 12. So now there is a shop downstairs which is giving the bottle at 15 rupees, and nearby there is no other shop, there is another shop which is 2 kilometers away which is giving the same water at 12 rupees, where will you buy it from? Why? It's not right price, why are you buying? नहीं प्यास इतनी नहीं लगी है, उतना रुक सकते हैं, दूसरी जगह से 15-20 मिनट में आ जाएगा, जाके लेके आना है। किधर से लेंगे? वेयर विल यू टेक इट फ्रॉम? डाउनस्टेयर्स और 2 किलोमीटर अवे। व्हाई? बचते? व्हाट डू यू फील? बचते जाने का रिक्शा का 20 रुपया, आने का 20 रुपया, बचते पैसे, पैसे बचते। वेयर विल यू बाय इट फ्रॉम? यू ओनली टू ऑप्शंस, आइदर हियर और 2 किलोमीटर अवे, वेयर विल यू बाय इट फ्रॉम? नीचे। क्यों? राइट प्राइस तो है नहीं, राइट प्राइस तो कितना है? 12 रुपीज, फिर भी नीचे से खरीद रहे हो, क्यों? नाउ यू रिक्वायर 500 बॉटल्स, कहां से खरीदोगे? क्यों? तो उससे क्या हुआ? राइट प्राइस बोला ना, क्वांटिटी ज्यादा होने से क्या हो गया? टाइम तो उतना ही लगने वाला है ना। व्हाई डिड यू चेंज योर डिसीजन? व्हाई डिड यू चेंज योर डिसीजन? हाँ तो उससे क्या हुआ, समझाओ ना, एक्सप्लेन व्हाट हैपेंड बिकॉज ऑफ चेंज इन क्वांटिटी। यहां पे लेने में क्या फर्क पड़ता है और वहां पे लेने से क्या फर्क पड़ता है? यस बोलिए, ये तो आप भी बता सकते हैं। हाँ नहीं हो रहा कन्विंस, नो क्वेश्चन, आपके पास ये दो ऑप्शन है, नो क्वेश्चन ऑफ कन्विंसिंग और एनीथिंग, फिक्स वेयर विल यू टेक इट फ्रॉम एंड व्हाई। हाँ क्यों?
क्वांटिटी हमारा ज्यादा है और तो, हमारा रिक्वायरमेंट जल्दी नहीं है।
हाँ तो
जैसे आने
तो हुआ क्या, क्वांटिटी बदलने से क्या फर्क पड़ गया तुमको? ये यही तो समझ में नहीं आया मेरे को। हाँ
यहाँ पर एक क्वार्टर के पीछे जो एक्स्ट्रा रुपीस हम दे रहे
हैं, हाँ
पर कम हो गया, अगर इस ट्रांसपोर्टिंग का भी खर्चा है।
सो व्हाट इज इट दैट यू आर कैलकुलेटिंग? प्राइस? और आर यू बाइंग बेस्ड ऑन द प्राइस? टाइम का तो वो कुछ बोला ही नहीं उन्होंने, तो टाइम सेव पहले नहीं करना था क्या? एक बॉटल के लिए टाइम नहीं सेव करना है? टाइम सेव हो रहा है तो इधर से खरीदो ना 500 बॉटल नीचे से। व्हाट आर यू कैलकुलेटिंग? Right cost is important. Price is not important. Materials management and purchase management talks about 5 R's. These are right quantity, right quality, right time, right place and right cost. Price nahi. Samjhe? In the first case, if you buy it from here, the cost is 15 rupees. If you buy it from there, price is 12 rupees, but cost is 52 rupees. 12 rupees for the bottle and 40 rupees for coming and going. In second case, if you buy from downstairs, cost is 7,500 rupees. If you buy from there, the cost is 6,040 rupees. It is the cost which matters. So purchasing or materials management has to talk about 5 R's. The fifth R is right cost and not the price. Is that clear? So cost is very important. And for any purchase, there are basically three types of cost which are incurred. One is the cost of the material itself. Second is cost of getting the material. Like when we talked about right now, one bottle versus 500 bottles. Irrespective of whether you get one bottle from there or 500 bottles from there, rickshaw charges are same, 40 rupees. No? And third is inventory cost. Cost incurred for keeping the material. Right? And these three costs, out of which material cost will not change with the quantity unless there is a discount offered. But with the change in quantity, your inventory cost will change and purchasing cost changes. Like if you buy more quantity, your inventory cost increases, but your purchasing cost will reduce. Like let us assume every day you require one bottle, right? And every time you go for purchasing, you have to pay for the bottle, that is a separate amount, but jaane aane ka kharcha, let us assume 100 rupees, right? Now, every time you go, you are spending 100 rupees. If you purchase 30 bottles together, what will be the total money that you will have to spend on purchasing during the month? Mahine bhar mein kitna kharcha hoga? Purchasing ka. 100 rupees. If you purchase 15 bottles every time, mahine bhar mein kitna kharcha hoga? 200 rupees, 100 every 15 days. If you purchase 7 bottles every 7 days, 400 rupees, 4 bar khareedna padega. If you purchase 5 bottles every 5 days, total to 30 khareedna hai na mahine mein, kitni bar jana padega? 6 bar, so 600 rupees. So if you buy in smaller quantity, your inventory cost will be low. Space will be less, na? Space will be less, money block will be less, chances of damage will be less, insurance premium will have to be paid less. So, if you try to reduce inventory cost, you have to buy less quantity. You buy less quantity, you have to buy more number of times. So that results into increase in ordering cost or purchasing cost. So you have to make a balance between the two. Because on one side your purchasing cost increases, second side your inventory cost increases. And to balance this, if we balance this, then that concept is called as, we'll arrive at a quantity which will result into overall cost being low. And that is called as EOQ, economic order quantity, where we are trying to balance between the inventory cost and the order cost. Let us understand what is this. And what does this mean? Inventory cost is Q by 2 into CU into I. Q is quantity that we purchase every time. So if we purchase 10 units every time, okay, you can write down this, then we'll talk. Suppose you still require 30 units of product every month. You have decided that you will purchase 10 units every time. So in a month, you will have to purchase 3 times. You purchase 10 units. First day, how much is the stock with you? 10. Second day, 9. Third day, 8. Then 7, then 6, then 5, then 4, 3, 2, 1, and finally 0. Average will be how much? 5, which is 10 by 2, which is the purchase quantity.